Hello everyone and welcome to Maestro is Ellen. Today's video is a part of a series of videos on calorimetry. In today's session, we'll talk about the concepts of temperature and heat. Here you see two pictures. One is filled of ice, the glass is filled of ice, and another is a picture of lighted electric bulb. When you hold this glass of water in your hand, you will feel cold. And when you touch the electric bulb, you feel hot. This sensation of feeling cold or hot is nothing but a qualitative measurement of temperature. What is this qualitative measurement of temperature? Is that if your object is cold, your temperature is low. If your object is hot, its temperature is high. Now, the temperature of a substance depends on the internal energy of that substance. And the internal energy of the substance is depend on the energy of its particles. Particles like molecules or atoms. Now, these particles possess energy in the form of kinetic energy and potential energy. The kinetic energy because of their random motion, while the potential energy because of their atomic structure or molecular structure. And the forces, the attraction force among those atoms or molecules. Now the temperature of a substance depends on average kinetic energy of these molecules or these particles. If your kinetic energy is more, the temperature of substance will be more. And if your kinetic energy is less, the temperature of substance will be less. So what we understood with this, the temperature of an object or substance is directly proportional to its kinetic energy, the average kinetic energy of its particles. Now let's consider two objects. One is cold, which temperature is TC, and another is hot object, which temperature is TH. So as we know, TH is greater than TC, right? Okay, so now if we bring these two objects in contact, okay, like this, what we observe that the temperature of cold body start increasing and the temperature of hot body start decreasing. Why this happens? What happens when you connect these two objects? The high temperature body molecules which are vibrating or moving with higher speed strike with the molecules and atoms of colder body molecules. And they transfer some energy to these molecules or atoms. And they keep on transferring that energy until both of these objects reach to the same temperature, T. And this condition known as thermal equilibrium. Okay? So once the two objects reach to thermal equilibrium, there is no more heat transfer in between those objects. So what does that mean? That means the heat transfer happens because of temperature difference. So if there is a temperature difference between two objects or two substances or two liquids, and if you mix them or connect them, there is a heat transfer. Heat transfer from high temperature to low temperature. And this heat transfer will continue until you reach to the same common temperature. Okay? Or you reach to the thermal equilibrium. Right? So now if somebody asks you if there is a heat transfer happening, then that means there is always a temperature difference. Okay? And if there is a temperature difference, there will be heat transfer and vice versa. Okay? So you understood the heat is the energy transfer in the process, okay? And temperature is related to the average kinetic energy of molecules of an object. Temperature of any object is measured by using thermometer, okay? And the unit of measure of temperatures are degrees centigrade, or in SI unit it is Kelvin, and in FPS system it is degree Fahrenheit. On the other hand, the heat is a form of energy in transfer, right, from one object to another object. The unit of measure of heat is nothing but the unit of measure of energy, which is joules or calorie or kilocalorie, right? You should know the relations between joules and calorie or kilocalorie. I just give you here, 1 calorie is nothing but 4.186 joules. So calorie is a bigger unit of measure as compared to joules, okay? So we can write down 1 kilocalorie equal to 4,186 joules, right? And similarly, here these, there are 3 different unit of measures. Here I will give you only one relation in degree centigrade and Kelvin. And here the degree centigrade scale start from 0 degree, which is nothing but ice melting point, 0 degree centigrade. And this ice melting point in Kelvin scale is nothing but 273.15 Kelvin. So 0 degree centigrade is equal to 273.15 Kelvin. Similarly, the boiling point of water is 100 degree centigrade and equivalent to 373.15 Kelvin, okay? So boiling point of water is in degree centigrade is 100 degree and in Kelvin scale is 373.15 Kelvin. Now if you see the difference here, temperature is 100 degree centigrade, right? And here difference is again 100 Kelvin. So when we talk about the temperature difference in degree centigrade scale and Kelvin scale is same. What does that mean? If I have temperature difference of 5 degree centigrade, this will be equal to temperature difference of 5 Kelvin. Okay, this remember this, the temperature difference is same in both the scales. Although the absolute temperature reading is different. So here we can use a formula to convert degree centigrade into Kelvin and Kelvin into degree centigrade. You can use this formula, degree centigrade equal to Kelvin minus 273.15. It means if you have given a temperature in Kelvin, for example, let's take 273.15. So in that case, equivalent degree centigrade will be, you put the value this in this formula in place of Kelvin, which is 273.15, and then minus this 273.15, so equal to 0. So this will be equal to 0 degree centigrade. Okay, you can take another example where you want to convert this 100 degree temperature into Kelvin. So I need to put this in place of degree centigrade, this place. So here it will be 100. Equal to, then I'm using this formula, right? I'm using this formula. So Kelvin minus 273.15. So equivalent Kelvin in Kelvin temperature, it will be 100 plus 273.15, which is equal to 373.15 Kelvin. So 100 degree centigrade temperature equal to 373.15 Kelvin. Here are top 3 concept questions from today's session. Answer these questions and put your comment in comment box. If you think you have learned something new from today's session, then please click like button and subscribe us for similar type of videos. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye.